Things went back to normal. Routines started up again. I was angry. I wondered why you looked okay. I didn't know what to make of you. You were so stoic in the wake of his death, and it confused me. Where was the pain? Why was I going through it alone? I still don't have it figured out. I'm stumbling through it, trying to understand. I know now that grief is constant and always changing. It was overwhelming. I was on autopilot, going through the motions. At some point, I hit a wall. I didn't understand what it was at the time, but I couldn't move past it. I knew education was important to you and Dad, but my heart wasn't in it. I was distracted, confused, angry. Not even a year went by before I dropped out. Time passed by while my body continued without me. I avoided your calls. I couldn't tell you I left school. It wasn't any of your business. The weight in my chest grew heavier. Every move was exhausting. When I try to remember this time in my life, it's like there's pieces missing, gaps where there shouldn't be. I found a dishwashing job a while after. I figured I needed something to do, something to focus my energy on. Anything was better than nothing. To my surprise, I liked it. It felt good knowing my work helped the kitchen. One day, I was asked to step on the line because we were short-staffed. It didn't take long to realize I was good at it. Being in a completely new kitchen was freeing. I got to create my own identity, my own rules. Who was I, independent of you? Figuring out my place was equal parts exciting and confusing, a new challenge to be faced alone. I made so many good memories in this kitchen. Food was so fun when I was a kid, finding new flavors and textures, an adventure we took together. My excitement only grew as I got older. I began to explore the possibilities and found myself happy, wanting more. It felt good finding that fire again. It was missing for a long time. You taught me how to hold a knife so I wouldn't cut myself. You gave me confidence in the kitchen. It became muscle memory, like second nature, almost as easy as breathing. There I was. 6 years old again, trying my best to help you without getting in your way. My first day of jumping on the line, I knew this is what I wanted to do. I practiced at home, put what you taught me to use. The confidence you instilled reminded me I wasn't bad at this. I would get better fast. I have this knowledge of our culture, of everything you taught me. What do I do with it all? It's intimidating. Is this how you felt too, when you were teaching me? Were you worried about losing yourself? That no one would remember what your mother taught you? You were very particular about the process of cooking. There wasn't room for creativity. A recipe had to be followed. The gyoza had to be folded a certain way. That mindset, that need for perfection, is what I retained. Keep a tidy workstation and kitchen, clean as you go. When I got older, you started working more. We spent less time cooking together. But I was determined to keep it up.